For over 50 years, the horizon has been dominated by the cooling towers of Ferry Bridge coal-fired power station. It's been shut down for the last 3 years. In the next 24 hours, 4 of the remaining 7 towers are due for explosive demolition.
I don't understand why I feel so attached to the cooling towers, but I really do feel attached to the cooling towers. It's absolutely bonkers, but I really do feel attached to them. I just don't understand why. A lot of people do say they're ugly, they're an eyesore, they need to get rid of them. But I just love them. How can you be so passionate about a piece of concrete? It's crazy, but I am.
It's been a long relationship too for Mildred Richardson, who's lived right underneath the giant monoliths for 45 years, living in the shadow of icons over 100 metres high.
When you look, they're massive, aren't they?
But in 24 hours, a series of well-planned explosions will turn 4 of the towers into a pile of dust.
That one, and two at back. Not these 3 here. They're staying.
Cooling tower number 6 is already on the ground after a test explosion in July. Now, 3 months later, towers 4, 5, 7, and 8 will be blown down simultaneously. Cooling towers 1, 2, and 3 will remain untouched. Anyone living nearby will be evacuated.
I'm only gonna leave it in the box. I'm happy enough here. I don't want to move. So I don't want my house knocking down. I won't like it to come this way and knock our place out.
They're closing your route to incoming traffic at R7, but that's for incoming traffic.
The power station's been Mildred's close neighbour for 45 years. But since its closure in 2016...
I'm officially at the top of the world. It's so high up here.
It's been a tourist attraction for urban explorers. Don't try this at home.
That is where we've come from earlier on. The bit with the smoke is obviously still in use. The big bit over there that's grey is still in use. This bit isn't used, and the big towers are getting bulldozed or exploded or whatever.
Everything from coal delivery by barge on the canal.
Look at this.
To the abandoned control rooms.
They've got the keys still in there to operate it, though.
The power station deserted, the way it was left on the last day of operation. But today, the site is in lockdown. The Scrap Kings have laid their explosives. And in less than an hour, 4 of the remaining 7 towers will be blown down, radically changing the horizon for the local residents. Cafe owner Jackie Emerson is amongst the crowds.
There's lots of people here. Streets full of them, if you can see.
Jackie wishes they weren't being blown up.
Nervous about this. Gonna miss them. Gonna miss them, Brian. You're not, are you? You don't like them. I like them, he doesn't like them. Are you gonna miss them, Barbara?
Oh, yes, I am, definitely.
I'm gonna miss them.
Elsewhere, homes and garden ornaments are abandoned as Mildred Richardson watches from further away at her daughter's house.
I think it'd be funny him not being there. But we should get a lot more sun when they've gone.
Mildred's neighbour Lee Scott and his family have also lived with the towers for a long time. Prime position for the theatre of demolition will be the middle floor of their house. Down in the streets next to the power station, Jackie's anticipation is tinged with melancholy.
It's not going to be the same. It is going to be a sad, sad day.
With 30 seconds to go, the warning blast is fired.
Whoa! Just heard a bang.
With just 10 seconds to go, no one knows what will happen next.
Wow! They should be cheering now.
Over 50 years of history wiped out in just a few seconds.
Wow! I'm actually shaking like crazy.
What the actual owl?
That was epic! Wow!
I don't know what to say.
Jesus!
Jesus Christ, I'm shaking.
That proper shook the house.
I'm not joking.
What the actual owl?
God, that looks just so different now. Just masses of smoke. I proper feel sad now, I really do feel sad. Me and Barbara sat down with Barbara.
Yeah, I'm very sad, me, yeah.
Yeah.
It's part of Ferrybridge heritage.
Yeah, it is, yeah. It is. It's part of heritage and it's just gone in a puff of smoke like that.
Yeah, it's
awful. Such a sad day.
And for Mildred, her giant neighbours of 45 years are gone.
All that muck. I bet my house is a right state. Bloody hell, they went quick, didn't they? I don't fancy all that, all over my house, windows and such.
The horizon is changed forever for the residents of and travellers through West Yorkshire, with the last three towers scheduled for demolition in a matter of months. Back home, the ornaments can be returned to the mantelpiece.
Oh, dear.
But for Mildred, the outlook has changed forever.
It just seems really funny looking out and I'm not being there.
The house has survived and so have the garden ornaments.
It's funny just seeing them go. I've lived here and they've been dead all my life. It's definitely a lot lighter.
A few weeks later on site, the Scrap Kings have cleared most of the rubble. Four stone circles of dust and concrete blown down from a great height. A footprint of where the towers once stood.